When I was but a youngster, Christmas meant one thing, that I'd be getting lots of toys that day. I learned a whole lot different when Mother set me down and taught me to spell Christmas this way.
C is for the Christ child born up on this day. H for herald angels in the night. R means our Redeemer. I means Israel. S is for the star that shone so bright. T is for three wise men, they who traveled far. M is for the manger where he lay. A is for all he stands for. S means shepherds came. And that's why there's a Christmas Day.
Here begins the good news about Jesus the Messiah, the Son of God. Most honorable Theophilus, many people have written accounts about the events that took place among us. They use as a source materials the reports circulating among us from the early disciples and other eyewitnesses of what God has done in fulfillment of his promises. Having carefully investigated all these accounts from the beginning, I have decided to write a careful summary for you to reassure you of the truth of all that you were taught. In the beginning, the Word already existed. He was with God. He was God. He was in the beginning with God. He created everything there is. Nothing exists that he did not make. Life itself is in him. And the life gives light to everyone. That light shines through the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it. God sent John the Baptist to tell everyone about the light so that everyone might believe because of his testimony. John himself was not the light. He was only a witness to the light. The one who is the true light, who gives light to everyone, was going to come into the world. But although the world was made through him, the world didn't acknowledge him when he came. Even in his own land, among his own people, he was not accepted. But to all who believed him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. They are reborn. This is not the physical birth resulting from human passion or plan. This rebirth comes from God. So the Word became human and lived here on the earth among us. He was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. And we have seen his glory, the glory of the only Son of the Father. John pointed him out among the people. He shouted to the crowds, "This is the one I was talking about," when he said, "Someone is coming who is far greater than I am, for he existed long before I did." We have all benefited from the rich blessings he brought to us, one gracious blessing after another. For the law was given through Moses. God's unfailing love and faithfulness came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but his only Son, who he himself is God. He is near the Father's heart. He has told us about him.
Cheer, thy spirit by thy hand.
pierce the gloomy clouds of night, and death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O
It all begins with a Jewish priest, Zechariah, who lived when Herod was king of Judea. Zechariah was a member of the priestly order, Abijah. His wife, Elizabeth, was also from the priestly line of Aaron. Zechariah and Elizabeth were righteous in God's eyes, careful to obey all the Lord's commandments and regulations. They had no children because Elizabeth was barren, and now they were both very old. One day, Zechariah was serving in the temple for his priestly order was that week. As was the custom of the priests, he was chosen by lot to enter the sanctuary and burn incense in the Lord's presence. While the incense was being burned, a great crowd stood outside praying. Zechariah was in the sanctuary when the angel of the Lord appeared, standing right in front of the altar of incense. Zechariah was overwhelmed with fear. But the angel of the Lord said, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, for God has heard your prayer, and your wife, Elizabeth, will bear you a son, and you are to name him John. You will have great joy and gladness, and many will rejoice with you at his birth, for he will be great in the eyes of the Lord. He must never touch wine or liquor, and he will be filled with the Holy Spirit even at his birth. And he will persuade many Israelites to turn to the Lord their God. He will turn the hearts of the fatherless to their children, and he will change disobedient minds to accept godly wisdom." Zechariah said to the angel, "How can I know this will happen? I'm an old man, and my wife is well along in years." Then the angel said, "I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God. And it was he who sent me to bring you this good news. And now, since you didn't believe what I said, you won't be able to speak until the child is born. For my words will certainly come true at the proper time." Meanwhile, the people were waiting for Zechariah to come out, wondering why he was taking so long. When he finally did come out, he couldn't speak to them. Then they realized from his gestures that he must have seen a vision in the temple sanctuary. He stayed at the temple until his term of service was over, and then he returned home. Soon afterward, his wife Elizabeth became pregnant and went into seclusion for 5 months. How kind the Lord is, she explained. He has taken away my disgrace of having no children. In the 6th month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you." Confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think of what this could mean. "Don't be frightened, Mary," the angel told her, "for God has decided to bless you. You will become pregnant and have a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will be very great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. And he will reign over Israel forever. His kingdom will never end." Mary asked the angel, said, "But how can I have a baby? I'm a virgin." The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby born to you will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. What's more, your relative Elizabeth has become pregnant in her old age. People used to say she was barren, but she's already in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible with God. Mary responded, I am the Lord's servant, and I am willing to accept whatever he wants. May everything you have said come true. And the angel left her. A few days later, Mary hurried to the hill country of Judea, to the town where Zechariah lived. She entered the house and greeted Elizabeth. At the sound of Mary's greeting, Elizabeth's child leaped within her, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Elizabeth gave a glad cry and exclaimed to Mary, You are blessed by God above all other women, and your child is blessed. What an honor this is, that the mother of my Lord leapt for joy the instant I heard your voice. You are blessed because you believed that the Lord would do what he had said. Mary responded, Oh, how I praise the Lord, how I rejoice in God my Savior, for he took notice of his lowly servant girl, and now generation after generation will call me blessed. For he, the mighty one, is holy, and he has done great things for me. His mercy goes on from generation to generation to all who fear him. His mighty arm does tremendous things. How he scatters the proud and the haughty ones. He has taken princes from their thrones and exalted the lowly. He has satisfied the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty-handed. And how he has helped his servant Israel. He has not forgotten his promise to be merciful. For he promised our ancestor Abraham and his children to be merciful to them forever. Mary stayed with Elizabeth about 3 months and then went back to her own home. Now it was time for Elizabeth's baby to be born, and it was a boy. The word spread quickly to her neighbors and relatives that the Lord had been very kind to her, and everyone rejoiced with her. When the baby was 8 days old, all the relatives and friends came for the circumcision ceremony. They wanted to name him Zechariah after his father, but Elizabeth said no. His name's John. What? They exclaimed. There's no one in all of your family by that name. So they asked the boy's father, communicating to him by making gestures. He motioned for a writing tablet, and to everyone's surprise, he wrote, "His name is John." Instantly, Zechariah could speak again, and he began praising God. Wonder fell over the whole neighborhood, and the news of what had happened spread throughout the land of the Judean hills. Everyone who had heard about it reflected on these events and asked, "I wonder what kind of child this will turn out to be. For the hand of the Lord is surely upon him in a special way." Then his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and gave this prophecy. "Praise the Lord, the God of Israel, because he has visited his people and redeemed them. He has sent us a mighty Savior from the royal line of his servant David, just as he promised through his holy prophets long ago. Now we will be saved from our enemies and from all who hate us. He has been merciful to us, or to our ancestor, by redeeming his sacred covenant with them, the covenant he gave to our ancestor Abraham. We have been rescued from our enemies so we can serve God without fear, in holiness and righteousness forever. And you, my little son, will be called the prophet of the Most High, because you will prepare the way of the Lord. You will tell his people how to find salvation through the forgiveness of their sins. Because of God's tender mercy, the light from heaven is about to break upon us. The light to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to give us the path of peace." John grew up and became strong in the Spirit. He lived out of the wilderness until he began his public ministry to Israel.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy was a heaven's perfect lamb? And the sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am. Amen.
Now, this is how Jesus the Messiah was born. His mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph, But while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant by the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her fiancé, being a just man, decided to break off the engagement quietly so as not to disgrace her publicly. As he considered this, he fell asleep, and an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph, son of David," the angel said, "do not be afraid to go ahead with your marriage to Mary, for the child within her has been conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All of this happened to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophet, "Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and he will be called Emmanuel," meaning God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord commanded. He brought Mary home to be his wife, but she remained a virgin until her son was born, and Joseph named him Jesus. At the time, the Roman Emperor Augustus decreed that a census should be taken throughout the Roman Empire. This was the first census taken since Quirinius was governor of Syria. All returned to their own towns to register for the census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, his fiancée, who was obviously pregnant by this time. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the village inn. That night, some shepherds were out in the fields outside the village guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were very frightened, but the angel assured them, "Do not be afraid. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born tonight in Bethlehem, the city of David. And this is how you will recognize him. You will find a baby lying in a manger, wrapped snugly in strips of cloth." Suddenly the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God. "Glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to all who God favors." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Come, let us go to Bethlehem. Let us see this wonderful thing that has happened, which the Lord told us about." They ran to the village and found Mary and Joseph. And there was the baby lying in the manger. Then the shepherds told everyone what happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's stories were astonished, but Mary quietly treasured these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their fields and flocks, glorifying and praising God for what the angel had told them, and because they had seen the child, just as the angel had said.
Angels from the realms of glory, wing your flight over the earth. Ye who sang creation's story, now proclaim Messiah's birth.
Eight days later, when the baby had been circumcised, he was named Jesus, the name given to him by the angel even before he was conceived. Then it was time for the purification offering, as required by the law of Moses. So his parents took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. The law says, if a woman's first child is a boy, he must be dedicated to the Lord. So they offered a sacrifice according to what was required in the law of Moses, either a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man by the name of Simeon who lived in Jerusalem. He was a righteous and very devout man. He was filled with the Holy Spirit, and he was eagerly expecting the Messiah to come and rescue Israel. The Holy Spirit had revealed to him that he would not die until he had seen the Lord's Messiah. That day, the Holy Spirit led him to the temple. So when Mary and Joseph came to present Jesus as the law required, Simeon was there. He took the child in his arms and praised God, saying, Lord, now I can die in peace. As you promised me, I have seen the Savior you have given to all people. He is a light to reveal God to the nations, and he is the glory of your people Israel. Joseph and Mary was amazed at what was being said about Jesus. Then Simeon blessed him and said to Mary, "This child will be rejected by man in Israel, and it will be to their undoing. But he will be the greatest joy to many others. Thus, the deepest thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your very soul." Anna, a prophet, was also in the temple. She was the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher, and she was very old. She was a widow, for her husband had died after 7 years of marriage. She was now 84 years old. She never left the temple, but stayed there day and night, worshiping God with fasting and prayer. She came along just as Simeon was talking with Mary and Joseph, and she began praising God. She talked about Jesus to everyone who had been waiting for the promised king to come and deliver Jerusalem. When Jesus' parents had fulfilled all the requirements of the law, they returned home to Nazareth in Galilee. There the child grew up, healthy and strong. He was filled with wisdom beyond his years, and God placed his special favor upon him. Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the reign of King Herod. About that time, some wise men from the eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem asking, "Where is this newborn king of the Jews? We have seen his star and we have come to worship him." Herod was deeply disturbed by their questions. He called a meeting of the leading priests and teachers of religious law. "Where did the prophet say Messiah would be born?" he asked them. "In Bethlehem," they said, "for this is what the prophet wrote. O Bethlehem of Judea, you are not just a lowly village in Judah, for a ruler will come from you who will be the shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod sent a private message to the wise men asking them to come see him. After this meeting, he learned the exact time when they first saw the star. He told them, "Go to Bethlehem, search carefully for the child, and when you find him, come back and tell me so that I can go worship him too." After this interview, the wise men went their way. Once again, the star appeared to them, guiding them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place called, or the place where the child was born. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house where the child and his mother Mary were, and they fell down before him and worshipped him. Then he opened the treasure chest and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But when it was time to leave, they went home another way because God warned them in a dream not to return to Herod.
Just to find God's new king, we know he has been born. King seekers traveling, where the magi following, one bright star wandering, where has he been born? We visited the palace with Herod breathing malice. The scripture men said Bethlehem was where the king would be. King seekers traveling, miles and miles adventuring, just to find God's new king, we know he has been born. King seekers traveling, where the magi following, one bright star wandering, where has he been born? The star shone up above us, it led us straight to Jesus. With gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh, we worshipped him. King seekers traveling, miles and miles adventuring, just to find God's new king, we know he has been born. King seekers traveling, where the magi following, one bright star wandering, where has he been born? A adventuring, just to find God's new King. We know He has been born. King seekers traveling, where the Magi following, one bright star now we sing. Jesus has been born. Jesus has been born. Jesus Christ is born.
Y'all, behave over there. After the wise men were gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. "Get up and flee to Egypt with the child and his mother," the angel said. "Stay there until I tell you to return, because Herod is going to try to kill the child." That night, Joseph left for Egypt with the child and his mother Mary, and they stayed there until Herod's death. This fulfilled what the Lord had spoken through the prophet, "I called my son out of Egypt." Herod was furious when he learned that the wise men had outwitted him. He sent soldiers to kill all the boys in and around Bethlehem who were 2 years old and under, because the wise men had told him that they had seen his star 2 years earlier. Herod's brutal action fulfilled the prophecy of Jeremiah. "A cry of anguish is heard in Ramah, weeping and mourning unrestrained. Rachel weeps for her children, refusing to be comforted, for they are dead." When Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and told him, "Get up and take the child and his mother back to the land of Israel, because those who were trying to kill the child are now dead." Joseph returned immediately to Israel with Jesus and his mother. But when he learned that the new ruler was Herod's son, Archelaus, he was afraid. Then in another dream, he was warned to go to Galilee. So they went and lived in a town called Nazareth. This fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet concerning the Messiah. "He will be called a Nazarene." Every year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the Passover festival. When Jesus was 12 years old, they attended the festival as usual. After the celebration was over, they started home to Nazareth, but Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. His parents didn't miss him at first because they assumed that he was with friends among the travelers. When they couldn't find him, they went back to Jerusalem to search for him there. 3 days later, they finally discovered him. He was in the temple, sitting among the religious teachers, discussing deep questions with them. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. His parents didn't know what to think. "Son," his mother said to him, "why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been frantically searching for you everywhere." "But why did you need to search?" he asked. "You should have known I would have been in my father's house." But they didn't understand what he meant. Then he returned to Nazareth with them and was obedient to them, and his mother stored up all these things in her heart. So Jesus grew both in height and wisdom, and he was loved by God and all who knew him.
On this last song, we ask that you guys stand up and sing along with us.
Amen. Amen.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive. Sing and heaven in nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. course is found. Far as the curse is found. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love.
Get the light. Well, that concludes our